रिपोर्ट को सब डिटेल तपाईहरु समक्ष राखिदिनु हुनको लागि म जुरी यस आदरणीय जुरी का प्रमुख प्रोफेसर डाक्टर सुभाष केसीज्यूलाई अनुरोध गर्दछु।
थैंक यू मैडम। रेस्पेक्टेड मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस ग्रेट असेंबली एंड रेस्पेक्टेड मेंबर्स ऑफ HR fraternity. I feel very proud and privileged to stand here. In front of me I see not only an assembly of people but a great assembly of the makers of great people. I won't be taking much of your time because I'm not feeling that well. But since I have been asked to share with you, you know, some of the dimensions which we considered important for evaluating the institutions doing excellent jobs in terms of human resource policies and practices, so I will take a few minutes from you. But before that, let me quote something which I read when I walked into this room. It's by Stevie Wynne. I'm sure that this book is in front of each one of you. It's like this: human resources isn't a thing we do, it's the thing that runs our business. Very rightly said, very true statement. But let me also add another statements which I have read somewhere. Many times we claim that people are the most important resources in an organization. But I beg to differ. They are not. Do you agree with me? They are not the most important resources. People are not the most important resources. Right people are. You know, my philosophy of HR is finding rightness in people, finding rightness of people, finding rightness by people, and if I may build on Abraham Lincoln's famous quotation about democracy, it is about rightness for people. If we can ensure rightness in the organizations, in institutions, and in society, then we can turn people into the greatest capital civilization has ever invented. People are there for other people and for themselves. So if you can make people great, they will make great contributions for the entire humanity. So that's the potential. And that's the power of human resources. I'm so pleased to see so many HR professionals. Most of you, if I'm not wrong, are very young, the age of my children. But if you have made human resource your profession, I and my respected colleagues on the jury, we can be very sure of HR making the greatest contribution to human prosperity. Prosperity is nothing but an endeavor, an enterprise, and contribution of people. And it is the business of HR professionals to ensure that the greatness in people is achieved. People are facilitated, people are enabled, people are empowered to be as great as they are capable of becoming. But then, to me, human resource is not simply a profession. You may wonder, what then human resource is for me? It is my passion. I would like to humbly request all of you to make human resource not only your profession. You are this profession, you are in this profession anyway. Go a step further and make human resource your passion. It should be both your profession and your passion, or perhaps, if I may say so, a passionate profession or a professional passion, whichever way you look at it. Anyway, let me not go into that, otherwise I will be taking another long and sometimes very boring session. And I see some of my illustrious graduates around here, so they may have some objections about my taking their time for delving later. Let me come to this HR Excellence Awards. First of all, I must congratulate the architect or the visionary who thought of instituting this kind of award in Nepali corporate management. If I am not mistaken, this is perhaps the first time that human resource practices and policies and performance in the institutionalized forms are being felicitated, are being recognized, are being appreciated. It is long overdue, but as they say, better late than never. This is a brilliant idea, this is a brilliant vision, and this is a brilliant enterprise. And I must congratulate human resource meet authorities, and particularly the leader behind it, Mohan sir, and his team, and other collaborators, other supporters, other designers, and other implementers who made it possible for all of us to felicitate those institutions, those organizations who have done an excellent job in terms of human resource policies, practices, and performance. Although on the face of it, it may seem that these organizations are being felicitated for the excellent jobs they have done for turning their people into the most important and the right capital in the organization. But I think the message of this felicitation goes much beyond that. They are being felicitated not only for doing the best thing for their people and best thing for through their people. They are being felicitated for doing the best thing for the community, for the society, for the nation, and if I may say so, for the entire humanity. So this is something which we must recognize, we must appreciate, and we must felicitate. So may I request all of you to give a big round of applause for the organizers and the winners of these awards. So having said this, now let me come to the job I have been asked to do, to give you a brief overview of these awards. This is the first time this kind of awards have been instituted and put in place. The whole idea is to felicitate organizations achieving excellence in, as I said earlier, HR policies, practices, and performance. Its purpose is to recognize and promote institutional excellence in HR policies, practices, and performance that have resulted in superior human capital and better organizational achievement and better contributions to society and community. The awards, which we'll announce in a minute, aim to encourage the felicitated organization to continue with and further strengthen their best practices while inspiring others who, for reasons of practical constraint, I suppose, are not being awarded today, but they deserve such awards sometime in future. So the idea of this awards is to inspire them to create their own best practices for enriched national human capital. So this is the whole idea of, you know, these awards. Five different categories of awards in the field of HR excellence have been instituted and are being rolled out today, and hopefully it will continue in future. In future, perhaps we may expect some more categories. Why not? Let me share with you what are those five awards. National HR Excellence Award. This is the general category award. And this, there are four specific categories of awards. They are excellence in HR innovation and technology, excellence in employee experience, excellence in learning and development, excellence in industrial relations. With your permission, let me read out the fundamental idea behind each of these five categories of award so that you will have a clear understanding of what were the basic criteria for judging the award-winning companies to receive these excellence awards. To start with the National HR Excellence Award, this recognizes the overall excellence in HR practices, policies, and performance in the selected organization, the best design and implementation of the HR functions and processes, and the outstanding HR performance and impact, both within the industry and outside, and presenting a role model of HR excellence, inspiring others to follow. Now, Excellence in HR Innovation and Technology Award recognizes the best initiatives in introducing and implementing cutting-edge HR practices and technology to enrich human resource performance, leading in innovative HR practices and technology adoption to prepare for the future workplace. Third category, Excellence in Employee Experience Award recognizes the design and use of the best policies and practices to create a great experience for employees within and beyond the workplace, resulting in their high contribution and overall satisfaction, the best frameworks and culture, synergizing employee expectations, enablement, engagement, empowerment, and work environment. Next one, Excellence in Learning and Development Award. The specialist category recognizes the best strategies, structures, and systems designed for the learning and development of employees and the organization as a whole. An inspiring example of the accumulation and utilization of continuously updated knowledge and continuous adaptation and changes through the appropriate learning process for the sustained outcomes in terms of performance and potential enhancement. And the last category, Excellence in Industrial Relations Awards, recognizes the best practices for and outcomes of harmonization of relationship between and among all partners in running the organizations, creation of an industrial environment conducive for the well-being of employees and protection and promotion of the interest of management, labor, and society within the prevalent legal frameworks and socioeconomic conditions. So these are the five awards and their fundamental rationale. We have set out certain eligibility criteria, which I don't think is necessary for me to share with you, or because that will take time. And then we created a pool of organization for evaluation from the review of the documents available with growth sellers and based on the research works done by the very competent, very energetic, and very active research team of growth sellers, Himanshu Smith. And then, of course, we have identified specific criteria for each category. There are 10 criteria for the National HR Excellence Award and 5 criteria each for the rest of the 4 specific categories. And for each award category, we have identified 2 sets of criteria, different criteria. We have called them enablers and results. Enablers are those conditions which have enabled the HR policies, practices, and performance of the companies to be as good, to be as great as we have recognized them to be. And results, they are the criteria related to the outcomes of the HR policies and practices. We have given 80% weight to enabling criteria or to enablers, and 20% weight to outcome criteria, results. Again, I don't want to run through all those specific criteria. Okay, so these are the basic underlying ideas of, you know, these awards. I have shared with you, you know, the criteria, you know, the structure, you know, the process we have followed. What I would like to believe before I hand over this podium to our respected madam is that Growth Seller or HR Meet Forum, perhaps purposively or even perhaps unintentionally, has created one of the greatest platforms for recognizing the great things that institutions have been doing and intend to continue doing in the future to create the most important, the most critical capital for the prosperity of the society, for the prosperity of the humanity. These awards are about recognizing rightness. And that's the whole idea of human resource management. If rightness is the idea, if rightness is not the idea of human resource management, then what else is? So once again, I would like to congratulate, I would like to express my gratefulness on behalf of my respected jury members and on my personal behalf for taking this lead role, for taking this initiative. You know, the grand ideas, you know, the creative ideas, you know, the imaginative ideas and the groundbreaking ideas are not the cup of tea of all of us. But whoever comes up with these ideas and whoever makes it possible for those ideas to be implemented in terms of, you know, the visible results, in terms of the visible outcomes, are the ones who are the true leaders of the society, and we must recognize, you know, their contributions. So I would like to join with all of you to express our appreciation and gratitude to the architect of HR Excellence Awards, which from now on will not only set, you know, the framework for the high level of professionalization of human resource policies, practices, and performance in Nepal, will also be, I believe, an inspiring force, you know, for other enterprises, for other endeavors in the corporate sector and even outside the corporate sector to be recognized. As the chairperson of Growth Sellers said in his speech earlier on, that our society is not very, you know, very much into recognizing and appreciating the good things that are done elsewhere, or that we see elsewhere. In Sanskrit, they're just saying, you know, gun grahita. So I think they have started this process, and it is the responsibility, it is the duty of all of us, those who are present in this hall and those who are not present here, but who are working for the cause of human resources, making human resources the greatest capital. It already is, but it has the potential of becoming even greater capital, to support them now and in future, so that these excellence awards will not only become institutionalized, they also become, you know, the much awaited and much about, the much appreciated awards in the field of management in Nepal. So with these words, let me take leave from you Thank you very much for your patience listening. And lastly, let's give, you know, the applause to the winning organizations, which will be announced in a minute or so.
Thank you, sir.